Welcome back to College Game Day, covered by State Farm.
Bottom of the hour, we have Notre Dame and North Carolina State Women's Championship, Sweet 16. There is Olivia Miles hoping to shake down thunder from the sky. Irish faithful hoping to send a volley cheer on high, knock off the top seed in Bridgeport. And just a scenic drive down Route 8 in the Nutmeg State from here in our luxurious accommodations in Studio F. Bridgeport is where we find Rebecca Lobo. Rebecca, you'll be on the call for the Notre Dame-North Carolina State game. What are the keys that we should be watching for?
Well, I like that you're saying they're going to shake down thunder from the sky. We'll see if that happens. One of the huge keys in this game is going to be which team can control the glass. And it's so important for them. Both teams want to get out and run in transition, and they're going to need to get the rebounds in order to do that. And that's going to start with the big players inside. Elisa Cunane for NC State has led them in scoring all season long. She was in foul trouble in their second round game. She was also in foul trouble the first time these teams met. And as a result, Maya Dodson was able to take control. She had 20 points when these teams met in the regular season. Keep in mind that these teams have played each other once this year. One of the three teams to beat NC State was Notre Dame. So look at those two big players inside as a huge key.
I just like the record to reflect that Rebecca just lived out Billis's dream and took her earpiece out so she didn't have to listen to me. The second game that you'll call, Rebecca, is Indiana and UConn. What threat do the Hoosiers pose to the Huskies?
This definitely pose a real threat. This is an Indiana team that made it to the Elite Eight a season ago, the first time in program history. This is a team that has a lot of experience, a defensive-oriented team. They will look to slow down Connecticut. They will look to control the tempo in this game. And this time of year, especially to beat a team like Connecticut in essentially a home court environment, you have to have the experience, have to have been here before. Indiana has done that, and I think it's going to be a really interesting game for them that's certainly going to start on the defensive side.
Rebecca, hope you have a great call, as you always do. Look forward to watching today. Thanks for being with us.
Thanks.
How good was that?
She's amazing, man. So funny.
All Notre Dame's Olivia Miles has done in her first NCAA tournament is, you know, make history, becoming the first freshman man or woman to notch a triple-dub in a tournament game. Her Irish in for a fight with the number one team in the Bridgeport bracket. I'm talking about NC State, who are looking for their first Elite Eight appearance since 1998, led by Elisa Cunane. Sort of. The beauty of the Wolfpack's run in this tournament is that they had to rely very little on their All-American center to this point. The NCAA Women's Championship brought to you by Capital One. Half the field is set. Who joined South Carolina, Texas, Stanford, and Creighton in the Elite Eight? That is obviously a rhetorical question because we can't answer that until the end of the day, but we are excited to do just that.
Find out.
We will find out today. I'm Elle Duncan. This is Monica McNutt. This is Nikki Fargas. We're going to be with you all day long. A full slate of games for you, so buckle in, and they're on one at a time. I'm just saying, I know that really only affects us, but we're very excited about it. Four games on the docket today, including teams from the Wichita and Bridgeport regions. Number two UConn facing number three Indiana today. The Huskies eked by UCF in the second round in a game that Gino Auriemma described as a rock fight. So, Monica, anything that Indiana can glean from what UCF was able to do last Sunday as a defensive-minded team?
Oh, baby, pressure, pressure, pressure. Indiana would want to steal some of the pressure package that UCF showed. Now, granted, this is true to UCF's identity, connected on defense here, cutting off the baseline, the help side is there. On this pass, watch this rotation. Immediately on the catch for Olivia Nelson-Ododo. You got two bodies there. Errant pass. All the while, even though UConn recovers, eating away at the shot clock. Down to 16, maybe not the best shot from AZ Fudd. UCF cleans this one up ultimately by getting, well, not technically the defensive rebound, but they got the ball back. Here, Indiana does a good job. This is when they played against Iowa, and Caitlin Clark, obviously we know about her firepower, of staying in front. This is a solid closeout here. They play a lot of man. This is where it could get tricky for Indiana. They're going to have to protect the paint. Multiple guards for UConn can attack, going left or right, getting to that high post area, and they are money coming off that 1-2 dribble pull-up just like you drill it in practice.
Okay, Nikki, who's going to be the X factor for the Hoosiers?
Well, when you look at the X factor for the Hoosiers, you got to talk about Grace Berger. She's one of those players that will put the team on her back, and she has done so consistently. She's a player that when you get her the basketball, the game becomes easier because she plays downhill. She plays with a lot of passion. She elevates her team when the ball is in her hands. And again, this is a young lady that's averaging 16 points. She's the second in rebounding, second in steals, and leads the team in assists, and she can absolutely get it done offensively. With the help now, this is a team also that has a balanced attack. There's five players that score double figures for this team.
That highlight of Grace Berger right against Princeton for the winner, the spinning like layup circus shot pretty much defines who she is as a player. Let's talk about our game, the first game that we're going to see here today. I love my Saturday mornings with a little eggs, bacon, and revenge. Only three teams have beat NC State this week, or this year rather, and one of them is Notre Dame. Is there something that tells you it's going to be different for NC State this time?
Well, Notre Dame is playing great basketball. So is NC State, though. And I think when you look at the way they've played coming into this ball game, they shot over 50% from the field two times now. They'd had 11 and 13 scores respectively. And Alyssa Cunane really hasn't gotten going yet. She has to stay on the floor and make her presence known. She wasn't a factor in the regular season game.
She wasn't a factor. And I will say this, Notre Dame is better. Mm-hmm. Right. You can tell that NC State is better as well. And these two teams, high octane offensive. But I want to see what Olivia Miles is going to do. Let's see what she does in this game, because in the last game, she and Dotson both 20 points. Dotson Miles, 13 points.
Yeah. The Jersey girls are leading Notre Dame. Dara Mabry, yes, and Olivia Miles. On the other side, we will get you first half action. Diamond Johnson getting ready as well.
Presented by Capital One. This morning in Bridgeport, Connecticut, the first of four Sweet 16 games today on our ESPN family of networks. It's 5-seed Notre Dame taking on 1-seed NC State. Taking a look at our bracket. Last night, Stanford and Texas advancing to the Elite Eight. Meanwhile, the winner of this game will take on the winner of UConn and Indiana, who will play later this afternoon as we welcome you courtside. Hey, everybody, Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. So happy to be with you for the Sweet 16 on ESPN. We'll hear from Holly Rowe and Andrea Carter in just a moment. NC State, Rebecca, they have unfinished business after falling in the Sweet 16 a season ago. A lot of firepower on this team, but it begins on the inside with Alyssa Cunane.
Yeah, Alyssa Cunane is their centerpiece for NC State. She gets it done inside, leads them in scoring at 13.5 a game, 7.5 rebounds a game, just a consistent threat for them. She also will distribute from the post position, hugely important for her to stay on the floor. She got in foul trouble the first time these teams met.
Well, Alyssa Cunane joined by some other talented members on the offensive end. Take a look at the field goal percentages thus far in this tournament for the supporting cast of NC State. For a little more on the Wolfpack, let's send it over to Drea.
Thanks, Ryan. While you're talking about that supporting cast, you have to pick your poison against NC State. Do you pack it in the paint or get out to the three-point line? And if you watch their win against Kansas State on Monday, it really depends. It's not just half court, but it's also in transition. You have to find the shooters. Reyna Perez shoots 40% from the three-point line. You can't have all five defenders in the paint. That is like a layup for a sharp shooter. But it's also not just off the catch. Watch Diamond Johnson duck her shoulder like she's going to attack all the way to the rim, and instead she steps that left foot up and elevates into her three-point shot instead. They did not shoot well in the last matchup against Notre Dame, but all in all, this is a hot three-point shooting team, Ryan.
Well, it certainly is, Drea, and you know what? Notre Dame could be a hot three-point shooting team as well. They're coming off 108 points in an absolute whopping of Oklahoma, and Olivia Miles leads the charge.
There's a lot of really exciting young talent in women's college basketball. Olivia Miles is one of them, second in the nation this season in assists per game. She fuels their transition game, so important to what Notre Dame wants to do, always capable of finding her open shooters.
Miles, the first freshman ever to record a triple-double in the NCAA tournament, that's women's or men's, and her 23 assists in first two career tournament games, most by any player since at least 2000. Let's send things over now to Holly.
somebody say hot three-point shooting? Because I've got some for you right here. Notre Dame has a Mabry sister. That's right. People think she might have graduated, but this is the youngest of the three Mabry sisters. Dare is playing great right now with 7 threes in their last game. There has been a Mabry sister playing or coaching for Notre Dame since 2012. Michaela got things started off as a hot shooter. Marina set the school record for threes in her last season, as well as a national championship. And then here comes Dara, a transfer from Virginia Tech, the last of the three sisters, and she is making a name for herself. 7 threes in the last round, but she only tied Marina's record. She didn't break it. See if she can stay hot.
All right, Ollie. I mean, this should be an outstanding game to tip things off. The first of four Sweet 16 games this morning and afternoon on ESPN's Family Networks. You see what Dara did against Oklahoma, 29 points, a season high. Her sister, Michaela, an assistant coach now under Neil Ivey's staff, catching the action and keeping a close eye on her sister. Notre Dame won the regular season meeting between these two teams. NC State has not lost since. Wolfpack felt like they missed a lot of open looks in that game, but very conscious as well of trying to keep Maya Dodson not quite as active on the interior as she was in that contest.
NC State starting out in man-to-man defense. Key for them defensively is to limit dribble penetration, especially by Olivia Miles.
Here's Mabry on the attack, committed to the air, and got the roll. Notre Dame on the board first here in this Sweet 16 matchup. Taking a look at our Capital One starting lineups for NC State. So much experience. Reyna Perez, Kai Crutchfield, Ja'Kia Brown-Turner, Kayla Jones, and Elisa Kinane. As Perez can't rattle in a three, and nice job by Citron to guide the rebound over to her teammate. Miles and Sonia Citron, such an impressive freshman duo.
What a great save by Olivia Miles. She got that by inches.
And a little out of control, lost it. Nice footwork by Crutchfield to stay in bounds off the steal. Dodson working against Kinane in the post. Brown Turner gets it to Kinane. Blocked from behind, another chance, can't finish it. Good D on the interior from the Fighting Irish.
Those are the shots that Elisa Kinane and NC State are going to need to make in this game.
You see Notre Dame starting five with Citron and Miles, the two freshmen, joining Mabry, Westbeld, and then Maya Dodson, who is awaiting to see if she may have one more season of eligibility at Notre Dame. Otherwise, she would be the only player leaving the program at the end of this run.
Great high hands by Kayla Jones to disrupt the pass that would have been to an open player inside.
Here is Jones. Spinning, dishing, Crutchfield. Plenty of time to operate. Will pull up. Doesn't get the roll, but does get the whistle. And Kai Crutchfield will go to the line. Neil Ivey, in just her second season at the helm, has done such a fantastic job turning this program around quickly and taking it right back to where it's been for decades under Muffin McGraw. Last year, just 10-10. This season, a very live team in the Sweet 16. And Wes Moore in his ninth season at NC State. His team in a fourth straight Sweet 16, 0-3 in the previous three appearances. NC State has not been to the Elite Eight since 1998. They are 1-13 all time in this round. Here's Miles, carving through, couldn't whip it in, and Kinane, outstanding one-handed rebound.
And good job getting a body on Dodson. Dodson was terrific on the offensive glass in their previous meeting.
Oh, nice find from Perez, and Brown-Turner lays it in. NC State riding a 12-game winning streak. You see Brown-Turner averaging 12 points, 4 rebounds in the tournament thus far. Miles, pull-up jumper, roll falls in for Olivia Miles.
Notre Dame was working on that yesterday in their practice, understanding that NC State was going to go behind the screens, knowing that the pull-up jumper would be there for the guards.
Miles in the final five for the Nancy Lieberman Award for the best point guard in the nation. Miles hits the deck there. Crutchfield can't finish it. Mabry the rebound.
We've seen Notre Dame defensively play both man and zone, switching it up, trying to keep NC State off balance.
Mabry creating space for the little jumper.
You calling her little or the jumper little?
Just the jumper. Jones? No. Rebound saved by Citron. Here's Miles shoveling. Westbell doesn't get the roll. And Kanane another rebound. Kayla Jones was hurt in the first round of the tournament last season, which really altered things for NC State. Wes Moore calls her the glue of this team. Trying to go one-on-one on the interior here and couldn't finish around Westbell. Mabry gives it up. Citron on the attack. Up, under, and off, but gets the whistle. And the freshman, Sonia Citron, will shoot two.
Notre Dame's guards are dangerous because they can create their own shots, and there's no better way to create space than with the step back. Check out the distance. 4 inches. That's all the space she needs. Oh, 4 feet. That's the space she needs to get her shot off.
First foul on Kayla Jones as Citron misses the first free throw. We were talking to Neil Ivey about Sonia, and she said she may be the most unselfish player I have ever been around. Talked about how smooth the freshman's game is, how versatile she is. Citron, the ACC Rookie of the Year. 7-3 Notre Dame lead, and before the shot, we have a whistle. And it's going to be a foul against Mabry. That'll be her first. Crutchfield was wide open on the wing. Perez got it to her late. Here's Kanane, one-on-one. Now the double comes, trying to find space, able to squeeze it in.
NC State has to look for that. They have to look to get the ball into Kanane because she can score, but she can also pass when the double team comes. A little bit more patience offensively there by the Wolfpack.
Dodson can't finish it. Good D from Kanane. Perez wiggles between defenders. Here's Brown Turner trying to take the freshman off one leg and finish it.
That's a tough shot. Citron played pretty good defense on that possession.
4 straight points from NC State, tied at 7, a trip to the Elite Eight on the line. Mabry, no. Long rebound to Kayla Jones. As Holly talked about, Dara Mabry coming off 7 threes in the second round against Oklahoma. Perez can't hit. Jones whacks it out of bounds. It's going to stay here with NC State. Last deflected by Notre Dame.
Olivia Miles coming off with a little jumper. We know that is going to be true. And then for NC State, they're looking to establish their post game. Kanane with a step through.
The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? And in part by Champion, giving women the confidence to play by their own rules. Well, reactions from Notre Dame after their big victory over NC State back in February. And yeah, they were partying in that locker room. EL Ivey getting into it. And just a wonderful scene after a big win from the Fighting Irish. As we check out our game track brought to you by Adidas, you see the stats from that contest. Huge game from Maya Dodson, who dives on the floor here. We also saw Notre Dame so key in the second chance points. And Rebecca, when we talked to the NC State players, they really pointed out the emphasis of keeping Notre Dame off the offensive glass in this contest.
And particularly Maya Dodson, she had 7 of those offensive boards.
Kinane. Guarded by Dotson. One-on-one. Kinane goes up. In. Puts the foul.
Great patience. Great patience by Kinane. She got the ball, waited to see if the double team was going to come, and it doesn't. So then she makes her move. Patience. Nothing's coming. What do I got? And then goes right at Dotson to get the foul called.
It was interesting, Rebecca, talking with Elisa yesterday and her saying she has to be better about when she's one-on-one shooting, being in that attack mode. So far today, when Notre Dame hasn't helped, she's insisted on getting to the hoop.
Yes, she has.
A 7-0 NC State run to jump in front. Miles connects on a three. The poised freshman Olivia Miles.
How about her patience as well? Defender hedges out, hard hedge, and before the guard can recover, Miles takes the opportunity to shoot.
Crutchfield trying to get it into Kinane, somehow was able to, and the foul is called against Notre Dame.
Rebecca, I just love the composure of Olivia Miles. Just a hesitation, looking for her teammates, but still getting her shot. You mentioned it earlier, when the defense goes under the ball screens, she has the freedom to shoot, and she's taking advantage of it.
And that is a huge foul against Maya Dodson, her second personal, so she goes to the bench for Notre Dame as they send in Anaya Peoples. That one's going to deflect into the arms of Crutchfield. Another chance here for NC State. Diamond Johnson in off the bench. She can score in a hurry and in bunches. Brown Turner, little trouble with Citron. Shot clock down to 7. Johnson gets rejected. Peoples and Citron were there. Nice defensive stand there from the Irish. Peoples stops on a dime, can't flip it in, and Jones hauls in the rebound. 10-10, first quarter action, this Sweet 16 matchup. Johnson, great delivery, Brown. Turner can't knock down the three. Citron has it taken away by Johnson. Jones gets it to go. On the second opportunity there for NC State.
NC State had one of those exact same plays in their second round game against K-State. Just coming in, you don't see me, I'm gonna take the ball right out of your hands. The benefits of being small.
NC State, a number one seed for the second straight year. Last year was the first time in program history. And another turnover here from Notre Dame. Here is Johnson, weaving around Miles, right to the cup for two. Miles already with one personal. An 11-3 run for NC State over the last 3 minutes and 45 seconds. Peoples getting extended run here with Dotson on the bench with those two fouls. Miles will pull. Can't hit. Rebound. Fought for. One by Brunel. Les Belt short on a three. And the rebound to Kinane. Four boards already for Elisa Kinane. Johnson left alone. Short. Notre Dame controls.
Notre Dame is so dangerous when they're out in transition. It's a win for NC State if they make them set up and take some time off the clock.
West Bell trying to find space. Couldn't slip it in with the left hand. Here is NC State pushing.
And to follow up on your point, Rebecca, Nielle Ivey in the last huddle asking her team to run, to run. If you run, we will find offense.
Kinane can't finish it. Let's see if Notre Dame runs here, huh? Citron, a little hesitation, then some explosion. But again, NC State able to get back and get set up. Miles on the attack, cups it in.
Notre Dame's getting pretty decent lanes to the basket. That one they were able to convert, but there was a stretch NC State was scoring, and then of course Notre Dame can't run because NC State can get back in their date.
Wow, Brown Turner just beating Citron off the dribble. Ja'Kia Brown Turner is 4 of 5 from the floor in this opening quarter. She has 8 points. About a 16-second difference, game and shot clock. Miles giving it up. West Bell giving it back. Brunell, ball fake and a travel as Notre Dame turns it over. Fifth turnover of the quarter for the Fighting Irish.
We saw Miles with the mid-range game, the three, and here just taking it inside, a little flip-up finish on the drive. She is so cool and composed out there, especially for a freshman.
She makes the goggles work too, right? She said it's part of her look, doesn't want to go to contacts because it's part of her identity now on the court. No need to change. Only she and Caitlin Clark averaged 13 points, 5 rebounds, 7 assists this season as Notre Dame comes up with a steal. Mabry gets it off, but it is not on target, and that'll do it for the first quarter. NC State a 4-point lead at the end of one. Holly's going to talk to Niel when we come back. Second quarter action next. Start of the second quarter moments ago. Holly Rowe caught up with Notre Dame head coach Niel Ivey.
Well, Coach Ivey, you keep telling your team in the huddle to run, run. How can transition help you right now?
Well, I think that's our brand of basketball. You know, Monday night, we scored about 40 points in transition. Right now, I think we're surveying, and we need to go. You know, so we got to outlet and got to get stops and outlet and run.
All right, Ja'Kia Brown-Turner, that matchup's causing you problems defensively. What do you change?
Yeah, well, I'm going to try to throw some new bodies on her. She's a great driver, so we have to really rely on our help side. We got to lock up one-on-one, but we got to rely on our help side. Right now, it's not there.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Well, let's take a look at our thrilling drives brought to you by Nissan. Niel quite literally had a thrilling drive yesterday. She went to Philadelphia after practicing with her team to go watch her son, Jaden, and Purdue take on St. Peter's, a thriller. You can see mom certainly into the action. Her son, Jaden, just missing a look at the buzzer that would have tied the game, but St. Peter's ran, continued to the Elite Eight, and it's been quite a ride for Niel, Holly.
Yeah, she's been juggling that life with Jaden since he was a little boy. He's been around this program his entire life. We remember him running out onto the court when Arike Ogunbowale hit those shots to win the national championship, and here he is having his own March Madness moment. She does say it is gut-wrenching to watch him. She said, my heart is out on that floor. It's very difficult for her, and she said, I gave him a big hug after they lost last night, and he's flown home from with the team to Purdue.
Well, and Rebecca, that's at any age, right? That's youth ball, that's...
Oh, it could be a rec league game. As a parent, you sit there and your stomach is in knots all day long.
Nice bucket from Peoples to start the second quarter of this Sweet 16 matchup. Remember, Maya Dotson on the bench right now for Notre Dame with two fouls. Shot clock down to three. Brown Turner has it stripped with hands. Dara Mabry trying to bust it to the cup. She does to tie this game at 16.
Good job by Notre Dame defensively in a 2-3 zone that time. Active, taking away the inside. Active hands by Mabry.
Mabry now with 6 points. Jada Boyd in off the bench for NC State. Goes cross court. Brown Turner. Off the mark on a three. Boyd the offensive rebound. And the putback. Jada Boyd, such a key piece off the bench for the Wolfpack.
Two great plays by Boyd. To find that weak side out pass against the zone and then to get in there to get the offensive board.
Averaging 8.5 points, 6 rebounds off the bench thus far in this tournament. Prohaska in, great delivery to Peoples. What a pass from Abby Prohaska off the bench for the Irish.
Peoples got good position, but good position doesn't matter if you don't have a player who can deliver the basketball to you.
Spoken like a frustrated post. 2 assists on the first couple of possessions of the quarter for Notre Dame after they had none in the first quarter. They did have 5 turnovers. Good hands, Westbell knocks it out of bounds, and 5 on the shot clock.
In the 2-3 zone, you have to have active hands up top, and Mabry is able to do that. Deflects the ball, taking it the other way where Notre Dame is so good. Get out in transition and score. And then right there. You just got to get it to the right hand. If you send it to the wrong side, it's a turnover. And all the posting work goes for naught.
Boyd, baseline jumper is good. Jada Boyd, who Wes Moore has told us is the X factor for our team, delivering thus far in this second. Mabry, look out!
How do you leave her?
How do you leave her?
9 points for Dara Mabry, her sister, Michaela, assisting. Marina playing overseas, having a very effective start to her WNBA career. Wes Bell collects the rebound, pushing for Notre Dame. Good start to this second quarter for the Irish. Wes Bell on a triple.
Transition offense.
Since the start of the ACC tournament, Wes Bell has been on a tear, averaging 15 and a half points on 58% shooting. Was first team all conference a season ago. Out of bounds off of Camille Hobby. And now Kanane and Reyna Perez gonna come back in for Westmore.
Distance matters, Ryan. What are we settling in at? 7 feet away. Dara Mabry, man, you cannot be that far because she will drain the shot, and then Wes Bell stepping into the trailer three.
This is a Notre Dame team that can fill it up from deep. They've started the second quarter 5 of 5 from the floor after they were 5 for 14 in the first. Mabry looking for space, lost the handle. Perez has it. The get ahead in traffic, and a foul called against Notre Dame as Prohaska and Peoples were there.
And after that run by Notre Dame, Kanane back on the floor. That was a difference. You know, she's just such an imposing presence inside that you have to send multiple defenders to, even if she doesn't have the basketball.
Foul called against Prohaska, her first. A trip to the Elite Eight on the line. Winner will face the winner of UConn and Indiana, who will play following this game here on ESPN. Kanane battling with Wes Bell underneath. In the corner, Johnson can't get it to go. Follows it up with an offensive rebound. Another chance here for the Wolfpack.
You got to fake away and then give the ball inside to Kanane.
Johnson gets another look. That one she hits.
One thing you know, she's not going to stop shooting. If she misses, she's not going to stop shooting. That's what she's in for. That's her job. She's a scorer.
Well, she was 6 for 23 the first meeting between these teams. A game in which Kanane got just 5 field goal attempts as Miles hits another. A little bunny hop wheeling it in, and 10 points for Olivia Miles, and smiles from the Notre Dame bench.
Smiles for Miles.
Ooh, all right, nice. You know, this is our first broadcast of the tournament. You're already breaking out the rhymes, huh? Wes Bell knocks it away. Miles has it taken away by Johnson.
How about the energy plays by Johnson? Smallest player on the floor. Yeah, offensive boards.
Wes Bell comes up with a steal. Notre Dame is 6 for 6 in the quarter. Mabry gives it up. Great look. Peoples, patience, bucket.
Over and over again yesterday, Notre Dame worked on how they were going to attack when NC State went under the screens, and they're doing such a good job of it here in the first half.
6-point Notre Dame lead. They trailed 16-12 at the end of the first. Johnson dishes out. Perez wide open on a three. Those two can play very well together. Both capable of playing on or off the ball as Miles spins it in. How about the freshman Olivia Miles?
It's like she was holding it out there. See this basketball? I'm going to score this basketball. It was a children's book.
It's funny because Neil Ivey afterwards was in fact holding her arm out to pantomime the move. Perez, not that time. Citron off and running. Oh, Citron, what a move. And Crutchfield called for the foul. She'll shoot 2. Citron will when we get back.
Let me show you the basketball. Let me show you what I'm going to do with the basketball, Olivia Miles.
The NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One is brought to you by the Oscars. Tune in live Sunday at 8 Eastern, 9 Pacific, only on ABC, rated TV 14 DVL.
Coming up with a Degree Halftime Report, we'll dig a little deeper into that story that you heard the game crew hit on between Nyeal Ivey and her son, Jaden, and their journey to the Sweet 16. But after one quarter, you said, I need Olivia Miles to assert herself. What do you make of that second quarter?
Well, she must have heard me. It came through because she definitely asserted herself, scoring 12 points. But Olivia Miles is unstoppable.
Ooh, that is a tall task for the Wolfpack to slow down. Diamond Johnson, however, tons of energy, plays a big-time three a couple possessions ago. She's keeping the Wolfpack close.
Okay, we're going to get into all of that and so much more on the Degree Halftime Report. But for now, we get it back out to Ryan, Rebecca, Treya, and Holly.
All right, Elle, thank you very much. How about this second quarter for Notre Dame thus far? 20 points now. 8 of 8 from the floor, 3 of 3 from three. Did you like how we actually got to see the points change live there, too?
That's pretty impressive.
That's next level.
I mean, that's the pace Notre Dame wants to play. They want to push, score in their transition or in their secondary, play downhill.
Let's get a little on NC State's most recent huddle from Holly.
Guys, they want to make a change defensively and pay more attention to Olivia Miles. He kept talking about number 5 is hurting us. Communicate more. They also want to get the ball into Kinane a little bit more. Not fall in love with that 3. Look for her on the lob, and there it is right there.
Yeah, Holly on cue. Kinane, the footwork. Can't finish it. Did not get the whistle. Remember, NC State was leading 16-12 at the end of the first quarter. Notre Dame has just brought it offensively here in the second.
The reason NC State wants to get it into Kinane, they are 3 of 18 outside of the paint. 8 of 12 now inside the paint.
Wow. Impressed with that math and the stat. Miles, another 3. She is feeling it. A swaggy backpedal to the defensive end for Olivia Miles, who has 15 in the first half.
What a delight she is to watch.
Out of bounds off Notre Dame. Going to stay here with NC State.
Olivia Miles, how you feeling about your offense right now? All right, so the defense goes over the screen, but then gets caught up on her own player.
Another 3, Jones with that awkward release, can't get it to go. Here's Miles, pushing pace. Miles, confidence in her gait. Miles, step back 3, not that time, air balls it out of bounds. The NCAA Men's Basketball Championship Elite 8 begins tonight with coverage beginning at 5 Eastern, 2 Pacific on TBS. For more information on game times and networks, go to NCAA.com. Now keep in mind, Notre Dame is doing this right now with Maya Dotson on the bench for an extended period of time after picking up her second personal. This foul, I believe, is going to go against Prohaska, and it will be her second.
Yeah, she's getting physical with Kinane.
Now Peoples will check back in for Prohaska. I mean, how about that Nyeal Ivey is perhaps going to be able to go this entire second quarter with Dotson on the bench.
And it not hurting him.
Exactly. And Dotson was the key piece in the first meeting between these teams. A 3-point Notre Dame win back in early February. Kinane, what a move. She's been effective thus far in this first half when she gets touches.
Yeah, you just got to keep finding a way to get her a touch inside. She will make the right decision.
Kinane with 7 points. NC State a +4 in the paint. Citron nearly lost it. Throws it away. Good D from Crutchfield and Perez. Johnson dishing. Kinane the easy lay.
I love it. You know I love it when the big girl runs the floor. Kinane, that's just hard work.
9 points for Lisa Kinane. Peoples looking inside to Westbell. Trying to seek an angle. Didn't have it. Good D from Kinane. Jones pushing pace. NC State with a little rhythm now. Johnson penetrates, scoops, can't finish. And Peoples the rebound.
That's where you got to recognize your team's a little tired, and it's time to take some time off the clock on the offensive end.
Oh, what a dish. Miles to Westbell for the finish.
Underhand softball pitch.
Olivia Miles is in her bag. But a 16-second difference game in shot clock as that's thrown away out of bounds. And Notre Dame can just about hold for a final shot here.
We see Miles do this a lot, just playing with the defense and flicks the underhand delivery to Westbelt.
Miles with a cool 15 points here.
With a cool everything.
In this Sweet 16 matchup. Winner will face the winner of UConn, Indiana. That game tips at 2 here on ESPN. Citron, Brown Turner fell, thwarted the path of Citron. And that will be just the second team foul against NC State.
Overall, a really cleanly played game in terms of fouls, other than Dotson.
That's right. Here's Miles, flagging it down, 7 seconds left in the half. Miles, waiting. Miles, will she get it off? She barely does, and that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. Notre Dame outscores NC State 26-14 in the second. And it's the Fighting Irish who have an 8-point lead at the half over one seed NC State. Let's head over to Holly now with Olivia Miles.
Olivia, this is your first Sweet 16, but what allowed you to get so comfortable so early?
Yeah, you know, they were going under the screens. I felt like I was just, you know, reading the ball screen. I was going under, I was shooting my threes, I was hitting them, so I just stayed confident.
Yeah, you're getting your points, but you're doing a great job distributing. How are you keeping your teammates involved?
Yeah, I mean, since I'm scoring and drawing attention, and then I just, you know, dump it to Maddie, Dara. I'm just making reads again, looking for my teammates.
Thank you.
Well, it has been an incredible run thus far in the NCAA tournament for Olivia Miles. It's continuing here in the Sweet 16. 15 points in the first half for the freshman. Time to head to L. Duncan and the crew in the studio for halftime.
All right, thank you so much, Ryan. Talk about a scoring drought for NC State and a nice run for Notre Dame. And now we have an 8-point deficit for the number one team in the Bridgeport region, as we officially say hello, Degree Halftime Report. I'm Elle Duncan, that's Monica McNutt, that is Nikki Fargus. I'm gonna walk you through the swing of emotions we just experienced from quarter to quarter when it comes to Olivia Miles, who we just heard from. You went from saying, I need this young freshman to assert herself more, 10 minutes later saying, she is unguardable. What happened?
Was it 10? Was it a full 10?
It might not even been 10 minutes. What happened when Olivia Miles really keyed in this game?
Well, this time of year, it's really about your mentality.
Sure.
And she's one of those players that can take over, as we know. But the mentality for her for 40 minutes has got to be, I've got to be the aggressor. I've got to be the one initiates our offense, because she is so good scoring the basketball, not only for herself, but also for her teammates. Ooh. She is a multi-level scorer. Mm-hmm. She can shoot the three. So if you press up on her, guess what she's going to do? She's going to drive back by you. She's good in the paint because she's able to manipulate the defense. And I love the fact that she's also that player that says, I'm going to be unselfish when need be. But I like her being selfish, Monica.
I'm not mad at it. And listen, you can only have a heat check if you were hot, okay? Right. So I'm not even tripping off the last couple of shots that she took because she got going. On the flip side, NC State is just going to have to decide to stay in front of her. Like, she's so matter-of-fact, as you heard her telling Holly, they went under the screen, like, bad news bears, bad decision, should have done that. And she certainly made them pay. But on the NC State side, while Alyssa Kunane, particularly as the quarter wound down, you saw her assert herself a little bit more in the paint. She leads away with 9 points. To me, it's been Diamond Johnson, who was the sixth player of the year in the ACC, who has really stood out by what Rebecca called as her energy plays, right? This was a great moment, almost a defensive rebound possession for Notre Dame. She snatches the ball away, easy too. She hit a three in this ball game, and then defensively, she's just been all over the place. Here, she's gonna help lead the run out, push ahead. NC State was sort of stagnant a little bit in that half court. I think they're accustomed to hitting more threes than they've hit so far in this ball game, shooting just 18%. But to me,
her motor, just kind of being in the right place, right time, even if it wasn't the assist, maybe the hockey assist, has been really, really valuable so that this thing doesn't get out of hand for NC State, because for a second there, it looked like the Irish were about to pull off.
Yeah, this has been like the sticking point for NC State. They make it. This is their fifth consecutive time making it to, or rather the fifth time, the five straight times they've made it to the Sweet 16. This is where their season ends. We'll see if they can get over the hump. They're 1-13 all time in Sweet 16. Big weekend for Notre Dame head coach Neil Ivey. Obviously, she loves going into the halftime show with the lead, but also loves the opportunity to see her son, Jaden, also in the Sweet 16, the Purdue sophomore sensation known for his athleticism and his confidence. But if you want to understand his journey, well, you have to go back to his mom's.
The lead pass from Ivy. Douglas at the buzzer. Didn't get it.
Helping Notre Dame win its first national championship in 2001 was just the start of an exciting and life-changing year for All-American Neil Ivey.
With the 19th pick of the 2001 WNBA draft, the Indiana Fever select Neil Ivey from Notre Dame.
I was so excited about being drafted. I've always wanted to play professionally.
In her rookie season, Neil started 26 games. But in July, she began to feel unusually fatigued.
Just coming off of national championship, a long season in college, I just thought, you know, my body was just wearing down. So I went to the doctor and then found out that I was carrying Jaden.
On February 13th, 2002, Jaden Denaje Ivey was born.
I introduced basketball to Jaden probably when he was about three. I bought him one of the Fisher-Price hoops for Christmas, and then he started kind of shooting on the little hoop.
My earliest memory of the game of basketball, in the gym with my mom and the practices that she had, I was always in the gym.
I had dreams of making an all-star team, being a champion, but then after Jaden, I was just like, I'm a single mother, and I gotta survive, and this is my source of income, this is my livelihood. He was definitely my why.
After 5 years in the WNBA, Neil transitioned to coaching. In 2007, she returned to Notre Dame, this time assisting her former head coach, Muffet McGraw.
Like at a series where the posts are driving it and then they get a shot.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Yeah.
I think of the players like, you know, Skylar Diggins, Jewel Lloyd, you know, Rike Gumuwale, like all those amazing women. I was able to witness them and witness their greatness. They were my first role models, just found that love and that passion for the game from them.
There's a lot of things that he does, his mannerisms, and I'm like, that is completely Skylar or that is completely Arike, because he followed them and he learned from them. He's learned the game from strong women, and I think that's very powerful.
In 2020, Jaden took those skills to Purdue, where he currently leads the team in scoring and plays his home games close enough for mom to make the two-hour drive to watch him play.
When I know I'm getting close, I start getting nervousness for the game because I'm a different person as a mom than I am as a head coach.
It's going to be loud. It's going to be ruckus.
Come on,
Jaden. Boy, Ivy, a really explosive step, goes right to the basket.
Let's go! Let's go! The sky's the limit for him, and he's just scratching the surface.
My mom is my wife. She sacrificed so much to provide for me, and I'm just so thankful for her.
To just sit back and enjoy all that he's done and to watch him live his dreams is the best thing in the world.
And watch his dreams she did. After team practice in Bridgeport yesterday, Neil made the drive to Philly to watch Jaden and Purdue. Unfortunately, it ended up being, you saw him try for that last second buzzer beater shot, a historic win for the other team. It was the Peacocks of St. Peter, upset the Boilermakers. They became the first 15 seed in men's tournament history to make the Elite Eight. But just a fantastic story and the lineage of basketball, the talent that is in that gene pool, really, truly incredible.
Well, being a mom myself, when she talked about when she found out that she was pregnant and she thought, oh, I'm fatigued because I played a long season.
Right.
No, you have an unbelievable gift that you're going to bring into the world. And although the shot didn't go, there's so many great memories. There's going to be so many great experiences that Jane is going to be able to take with him. But I also love the fact that his role models early on in his
life has
been his mom.
Yeah.
And then the women who he
or who he watched play basketball at Notre Dame?
I love that too. And it just, women can coach, women can lead men's programs. The whole thing is just reiterated there. And while yesterday's loss, I'm certain, hurt for both Jaden and Neil, that baby's going to the NBA, okay?
Yes,
so
he's
got a very bright, bright future in the game of basketball. And it's just a wonderful example of how the game includes everybody.
Also, not a great example as someone that's been pregnant. We can't all play games at that level. So shout out to Neil. That's not real and not a thing. But also, we are coming back, and that is the thing. I'm just saying, her, Serena, they make us feel really bad. I can barely walk.
It's okay, Elle. You're good. You're good.
She looks fabulous.
This halftime report is presented by Degree. It won't let you down. Welcome back to the Degree Halftime Report.
Olivia Miles decided she was going to assert herself, and that's exactly what she did, shooting 60% from the field. She leads the Notre Dame Fighting Irish at the break. Second half from Bridgeport on the other side. This has been the Degree Halftime Report.
This halftime report is presented by Degree. It won't let you down.
Welcome back to the NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One. Getting ready to start the second half of this Sweet 16 matchup. Notre Dame, a 38-30 lead over one seed NC State as we get ready to start the third quarter. What a first half for the freshman, Olivia Miles. More on that. Let's check in with Andrea Carter.
That's right, Ryan. What a first half, and what a way to read the defense. Olivia Miles is a perfect example of how to read defense and having a feel for the game. Look, if a defender goes under two players, that is an automatic pull if you are Olivia Miles. Smooth jump shot. And then it's not for lack of effort on NC State. Look, there's a little bit of fight going through two. Still too much space. What makes it hard is if you go over the top, she is slashing to the rim. Olivia Miles has been hard to stop.
No doubt about that, Ryan Rucco, the Hall of Famer, Rebecca Lobo, welcoming you back courtside. Meanwhile, for NC State, Rebecca, Elisa Kanane been effective when she's gotten the rock.
Yeah, this is an NC State team that has been effective when they gotten touches in the paint, and primarily to Elisa Kanane, but they have not gotten enough of them. They are struggling from outside the paint, as you see there, 3 of 19. This is an NC State team. On the season, 37% from the three-point line, which ranked 10th in the country. They struggled in the first half.
Let's take a look at our first half stats. They are brought to you by Geico. And you see Miles with those 15 points. Notre Dame, 10 of 13 from LaFleur in that second quarter. They hit their first 9 shots of the second. NC State fell in the Sweet 16 a season ago to Indiana, who will play UConn in the next game here as Crutchfield gets denied by Dodson. Back in after two early fouls in the first half. Citron can't finish. Dodson blows the bunny, and Kanane off the rebound.
Dodson should be energized, though, here in the second half because of her limited minutes in the first as a result of foul trouble.
Played just 6 minutes because of that foul trouble. Kayla Jones kicks it out. Here's Brown Turner. Couldn't finish it.
Patience. They need more patience. Go off of 2 feet and finish inside.
Here is Miles. Bouncing away from the hedge. Westbell. Bounce it out. Notre Dame patient with this offensive set. Miles attacks, reverses, and gets it to go. And then gives the MJ shrug afterwards.
Putting the defense in a bind, running the horn set. Defender doesn't know which way she's gonna go, which way she should cheat.
17 for Miles. That three drives in for Kayla Jones, and a big one for NC State. To 33, Notre Dame in front. Good battle there, Kanane and Dodson. Dodson able to get to it and lay it in.
And you want to tire out Kanane and make her work a little bit more on the defensive end. Dodson can do that. Great job with the post up. Physical play inside.
First bucket of the game for Maya Dodson. Here's Perez attacking, dishing, good movement. Crutchfield, she got it on a three. In her career, 20 for 32 from three in the NCAA tournament.
A little more confidence from the perimeter game right now of NC State.
Six-point game. Notre Dame had a 12-point lead in the fourth quarter of the first meeting between these teams, and then NC State ended up making it a one-point contest, a one-possession contest down the stretch. Brown-Turner around the screen from Kinane, gets it back to her. On the attack, she lays it in. Better rhythm here for NC State on the offensive end. 11 for Kinane. She averaged just 8.5 through the first two games of this tournament. Averaging 13.5 per game on the season. Westbelt giving space, no. Good box out there and a foul called against Citron.
We've talked about how this freshman has tremendous confidence and swag. Tough shot, how does she feel about it?
Giving the shrug. Just talking with her yesterday too, Rebecca. She has such a presence to her for a freshman. Talked about being a leader regardless of age, and you can tell that she already is. Mabry, the hesitation, the attack, and the denial from Kayla Jones.
Anytime a smaller guard goes in the lane and a bigger guard is there, it's gonna be easy pickings.
Here's Miles working behind Westbelt. Miles. Oh, what a dime to Westbelt on the finish. Just a gorgeous pass.
And the big has to stay an extra beat because Miles was pulling and scoring off of that in the first half, and then she reads it perfectly.
44-38, Notre Dame in front of NC State. This Sweet 16 matchup, first of four games on our ESPN family of networks in today's Sweet 16 action. Perez with three to shoot. Perez shakes Mabry, floats it up and off. Jones nearly had the offensive rebound, but nice job by Mabry to slap it away.
Yeah, just quick active hands.
The shovel for Miles. Miles thought about pulling. Looking for some help now. Miles, another dime. Westbelt extra feed. Citron will fire. No. Long rebound is going to be flagged down by Crutchfield. Kinane. And a whistle. And perhaps, do we have an injured member of NC State? Look like Kayla Jones might have been banged up. She goes to the bench. We'll see if we have an update from Holly in a moment. Well, moments ago, Kayla Jones, who Westmore calls the glue of his team, headed back to the locker room. We'll get an update as soon as we have more. Let's take a look at today's Be Your Own Champion, brought to you by Champion. How about Olivia Miles?
She's been absolutely masterful, and how she's read things on the offensive end of the floor, knowing when to shoot, knowing when to pass, pushing the pace. Four assists right now, and just as impressively, only one turnover. The amount she handles the basketball for Notre Dame to only have one miscue so far, it's pretty remarkable.
Let's check in with Holly.
Well, Olivia Miles is so special, something Neil Ivey recognized immediately. She said, we are catering our entire offense to her. That is spacing the floor, getting her out in transition, letting her make her magic. She said, we have actually become one mind. She is me out there on the floor. We are one. They watch film together. They talk about what shots she can take to be successful and how she can get her other teammates involved. And Neil said she had all of the pressure of being a point guard at Notre Dame on her shoulders. I had all the pressure of being the coach, and we have come together to handle all of that.
Most assists through the first three NCAA tournament games since 2000. Some pretty great names on that list. And Miles, number three and counting, as Dotson able to finish an 8-point Notre Dame lead. Third quarter action here in Bridgeport. Remember, Kayla Jones got hurt in the first round last season for NC State. It was a big missing piece as they then lost to the Sweet 16 in a 3-second violation here against Canane.
And Ryan, we saw it in the last possession when Maya Dotson faced up and drove. This is a fast-paced game, and this has been a tiring game. Her bounce, again, because of the limited minutes in the first half, might make a difference in the second.
8-2 edge in the paint in this third quarter for Notre Dame. West Bell separates from Boyd and finishes as Boyd hit the deck. It's a 10-point lead for the Fighting Irish. Anthony Westbelt, 9 points, 8 boards.
There's been a real toughness about Notre Dame on both ends of the floor here today.
A 6-0 Notre Dame run. Oh, what a spin. Brown Turner with a beautiful pirouette. Miles. Dishing it out. Westbell dumping it a little too far for Dotson, and Notre Dame turns it over as Sam Brunell will check in. He's still to come this evening on ESPN. We'll have Tennessee, Louisville, South Dakota, Michigan, but before that, we'll have Indiana, UConn here on ESPN. The Women's NCAA Championship Sweet 16 all day long on ESPN in the app. Boyd unable to finish. Brown Turner gets fouled. Canane a little shaken up, and free throws coming for NC State.
Nice set by NC State to clear the right side of the floor for Boyd. She wasn't able to finish initially, but they run the stagger on the left side to clear her room for her to drive. Boyd was efficient in the first half.
That was interesting talking with Wes Moore earlier this season about his team's hunger. After falling in the Sweet 16 a season ago, bringing back their entire starting five, he said when they were getting their ACC tournament championship rings done, they were going to put back-to-back Sweet 16s on the ring. And the leadership of NC State, the player leadership that is, said, no, we want more. As Crutchfield misses a three. They are not satisfied with ending right here and did not want that to be acknowledged on their rings. 1-13 all time in Sweet 16s. NC State has not been to the Elite Eight since 1998 as Miles just whacks that out of bounds with velocity.
NC State's done a really nice job on the offensive glass. 10-0 boards. This is a story in the first meeting. Notre Dame beat them on the offensive glass. NC State's taking care of that. They just haven't been nearly as efficient offensively.
But we have seen where they can go from not hitting shots to hitting them in bunches in a hurry. Nice D from Dotson there. Here comes Notre Dame. Miles the lead. Citron lays it in. Puts the foul. Freshman to freshman and a chance for three.
Really good players make the difficult look easy, and that happens here. Olivia Miles coming down. She knows exactly where her teammate is, but she takes the ball to the side of the floor so that Citron has the direct path once she catches the ball to go in for the layup.
Kayla Jones coming back to the bench for NC State. Obviously a good sign for the Wolfpack. Citron, 6 points, five rebounds. Neil Ivey has asked Citron to take on more of a scoring role second half of this season. Perez, baseline jumper, won't go. Reyna Perez just 1-for-6 from the floor. Miles with some haste. Miles threw it too hot for Dodson and out of bounds.
It was the right read, though. It was the right read and right player to try to deliver it to. Just had too much heat on it.
You know, Rebecca, you're talking about it being the right read, but Olivia Miles coming off the screen also exhausts Alyssa Cunane because she has to make that hard hedge and recover. So when you talk about having legs late, that's going to be a factor.
Yeah, without question. That's a difficult defend for Cunane or any big to try to get out there quickly and recover to your own.
Jada Boyd has looked good in her minutes so far.
Yeah, she's been really good. Limited minutes in the first half, but she was 2 for 2 from the floor.
Boyd, 6 points now. 8-point game. A trip to the Elite Eight on the line. Prohaska in for Notre Dame. Mabry on the bench at the moment. Miles with 7 to shoot. Miles will fire. No. Rebound Cunane. Nice box out there. A chance for NC State to creep a little closer. Here's Perez. Have not seen Diamond Johnson yet in this third. Boyd. And a foul is going to go against Westfeld. That's just the third team foul against Notre Dame.
You mentioned Diamond Johnson not playing yet here. And 2 of 8 in the game. And NC State has been so much more efficient when they've gotten the looks and the touches inside.
Brown Turner out of the double. Good movement here. Crutchfield alone. She got it on the three. It's a 5-point game. Kai Crutchfield, they call her at this time of year. 2 for 3 from downtown. Notre Dame yet to hit from three in this third. Miles giving it up. Burnell lost it. Citron trying to make something of it. She ties off the window. 10 seconds left in the quarter. Brown Turner with 5. Crutchfield with 2. Crutchfield has to get it off. Can't get it to go. And that'll do it for the third quarter. Olivia Miles in Notre Dame, a 7-point lead after 3. We'll hear from head coach Wes Moore of NC State with Holly when we come back.
Welcome back to Bridgeport here with NC State coach Wes Moore. And coach, what have you been doing so intentionally since the second half started? Your offense feels different.
Well, I don't know. We've settled for tough shots. We got it. Again, Notre Dame's doing a great job defensively, but we got to make sure when we penetrate, we're making good decisions. We're reading the D. We got to get Elisa most touches whenever we can because she's being very efficient. But, again, just being on the aggressive, be attacking, but make good decisions with it.
How do you get her more post touches?
Well, they're making it difficult on us, but again, got to move her a little bit, move her around. Don't let her just stand in one spot. And then we got to make sure we're ready to feed her because she's not going to be open long. You better hit her quick.
Thank you, coach.
All right, thanks, Holly.
I think NC State's guards need to be better with their ball fakes. Fake and then get it into Cunane, because as he said, she's not going to be open long, and there have been multiple times where they're trying to get it in and they can't quite. Fake the zone and then get it inside to your big girl.
Cunane, no field goals last 7 minutes. Paige Becker is getting ready to take on Indiana next here on ESPN. The NCAA Women's Championship presented by Capital One continues next weekend. Final Four special Friday, April 1st at 6 Eastern on ESPN. Then the Final Four Friday at 7 and 9:30 Eastern on ESPN. All access Saturday at 1 on ESPN Plus. And the championship special Sunday at 7 on ESPN. And then the championship game begins at 8 Eastern on ESPN Sunday. All games are on the ESPN Networks and ESPN app.
One app, one tap?
That's right. You can figure it out in just one tap. If you're Rebecca, sometimes you need 2 or 3.
I need multiple.
Ryan Rucco, the Hall of Famer, Rebecca Lobo, Holly Rowe, and Andrea Carter. Happy to be with you for this Sweet 16 matchup, a trip to the Elite Eight on the line where NC State has not been since 1998. Oh, what a steal from Crutchfield. Like a defensive lineman on an interception. Johnson in for NC State. Brown Turner had a look in the corner, didn't take it, and now nearly throws it away. Still plenty of time for the Wolfpack to operate. Johnson on the attack. Lost it out of bounds to Notre Dame.
Yeah, Brown Turner needed to take that shot. She had the time and space for it because Johnson had the baseline dribble penetration.
And you can see Wes more than yelling at Diamond Johnson. Be tight with it, talking about the handle after that turnover. Here's Mabry. Citron unable to finish. Kanane the board. Elisa Kanane with 8 rebounds now. Brown Turner bounces out. Boyd. Step back jumper is good. It's a 5-point game.
Boyd is an elite level talent, and she's a player who can get her own shot off. She will be key here in the fourth for NC State.
Little full court pressure being applied now by NC State, and nearly a steal. Yep, it will be one. Crutchfield comes up with it. One-on-one with Miles. Crutchfield spins it in, plus the foul.
Ryan, earlier this season, we saw NC State with a monumental comeback against Louisville, and it started on the defensive end of the floor. They extended their pressure, they got more active up top, and they got possessions like this. Turnovers into scores.
Kai Crutchfield with 3 steals now, 2 at the start of this fourth. She talked to us yesterday about how her entire focus is on the defensive end. How she takes playing defense personally. And it's not a matter of when, but if someone's gonna score on her. So far in the fourth, they aren't. Crutchfield has NC State within 2. Fourth quarter action. The NCAA Women's Championship is presented by Capital One. What's in your wallet? Outstanding defense from Kai Crutchfield to begin this fourth quarter. NC State on a 10-2 run going back to the end of the third. They have made this a 2-point game, 8:35 to go in the fourth quarter of this Sweet 16 matchup, Holly.
That Kai Crutchfield feeds on defense. Well, she was watching The Last Dance and learned how Dennis Rodman used to watch rebounds come off the rim, nowhere to be in position. So she has started watching tape. As we see a nice bucket from Miles, she started watching tape on how defenders' feet are. She said, I can tell the way their feet are, how they're going to come off on a certain play. She is living that, but it's good from The Last Dance and Dennis Rodman. What a great idea.
Also an ESPN production, so we don't mind that. Johnson, hesitation, explosion, rejection. As Dodson was there tracking her.
And a great timeout by Nia Livy. Her team had a couple of turnovers, needed to settle them down, got the ball into Miles' hands, and Dodson, man, she's got length, she's big. Great job on the block.
3 blocks now for Dodson. Turnover here, West Bell chugging along, all the way in for 2. 4 straight out of the timeout has Wes Moore hanging his head for a moment. After NC State had just cut it to 2. Johnson, the Rutgers transfer, came to NC State because she wanted to be on a stage like this. In the corner, Brown Turner rims out. Rebound hauled in by Peoples. Here's Miles dashing ahead, dishing. Mabry didn't have the space, and we'll settle it down.
She didn't have the 4 feet from the first quarter.
Miles surveying. Here's Dodson. 6 to shoot. West Bell giving it up. 3 to shoot. Miles going to have to create. Miles a bomb. No. And the rebound flagged down by Peoples. Another chance here for Notre Dame. Just grazed the rim off the backboard. Miles around the back, scooping it up and off. Dodson is there for the foul.
Notre Dame did a great job taking advantage of Diamond Johnson's small size defensively. 2 offensive rebounds.
You mentioned the activity from Dodson, who played just 6 minutes in the first half because of foul trouble. Dodson again with that activity. Notre Dame on a 6-0 run after that timeout from Neil Ivey. Miles. Giving it up. Seven is Shue. How about Crutchfield? Another steal. Crutchfield all the way in for two. That's three steals in the quarter for Kai Crutchfield, doing everything she can. Crutchfield, Perez, Kayla Jones, Kanane, all could be playing in their final collegiate game. Miles in and out, was halfway down. Here comes Johnson, zipping into the front court. Finds the trailer, Kanane gets fouled. And Alisa Kanane will shoot two to try and make this a four-point game.
Kai Crutchfield, the graduate student, doing all she can to have her career continue for one more game. She has been outstanding here, in particular this fourth quarter defensively.
Dodson finally picks up her third foul after picking up two in the first quarter. Did not play the entire second. It's interesting the difference when you talk about experience and whether or not this could be the end of the road when it comes to these two teams, Rebecca, because for Notre Dame, the only player whose final game it might be is Maya Dodson, waiting to see if she gets another year of eligibility. For NC State, this is it for four of their five starters. Brown Turner, the only one who will come back. Pressure from NC State and a steal. Perez, a big three. Too strong. Kanane able to save it. Another chance for the Wolfpack. Down just four after two Kanane free throws. Kanane fighting off contact. Couldn't slip it in. Got the whistle. If it's Dodson, it'll be her fourth.
Kanane has been a rock. She has been an absolute rock all game long for NC State on the offensive end of the floor.
They'll call it number two on Westbeld. And Kanane, a second team All-American a season ago, first team All-ACC this season, and this is big for a big. She's an outstanding free throw shooter. Mom on her feet. Kanane hits both again. The projected number five pick in this year's WNBA draft has made it a two-point game. Pressure again from NC State. Here comes Mabry. Miles sees the gap. Citron meets Kanane. And NC State able to get back and set.
And at the two-man game with Olivia Miles and a big, she makes the right decision.
Miles with 19 points. There is the two-man game with Westbeld. One to shoot. Westbeld, did she get it off? I don't believe she did. A shot clock violation as Notre Dame turns it over. And a timeout. 4:29 to go in the fourth quarter of a Sweet 16 matchup. Emotions high, a lot on the line. And Notre Dame leading by two. What's at stake with a two-point game with under 5 minutes to go? Well, Notre Dame looking for its first Elite Eight appearance since 2019. NC State would have its first Elite Eight appearance since 1998. Let's check in with Holly.
Well, guys, Neil Ivey asked her team to improve their spacing. She gave them several offensive options, but at the end of the timeout, she looked at the team and said, listen, breathe, everyone. Take a deep breath right now. She needs this young group to settle down right now and perform, make quick decisions, and run their offense.
Because, of course, Holly, especially the freshmen, they have not been in this moment before for Notre Dame. NC State's players have.
Perez can't hit the jumper. Miles, the get ahead for Citron, and it was a little too dangerous for that moment. Notre Dame turns it over. Six turnovers in the fourth quarter for Notre Dame. Winner will play the winner of Connecticut and Indiana. That game up next on ESPN. Great feed. Kunane couldn't quite handle it. And it's out of bounds to Notre Dame. Still to come today on ESPN, 4 p.m. We have Tennessee, Louisville, 6:30, South Dakota, and Michigan. The Women's NCAA Championship Sweet 16 today at 4 and 6:30 Eastern on ESPN and the ESPN app. Two-point game. Citron being guarded by Brown Turner. Draws two. Mabry was open in the corner, but no angle for Westbelt to get it there. Here's Miles, five to shoot. Miles looking to find some space. Oh, what a find! Westbelt lays it in!
For Miles to have the exact pulse of the clock on that possession, knew she had time to deliver it.
13 points, 8 rebounds for Westbelt, 19 points, 6 assists for Miles. Brown Turner didn't get the roll. Dodson came over, maybe got a little piece.
I think she did.
She already had 3 blocks thus far today. And now Miles calmly walking it across the timeline. Miles trying to work Crutchfield. Gets some space. Fires. No. Rebound. Bounces around. Brown Turner after it. Has it. NC State with the ball down 4. Diamond Johnson on the bench right now for NC State. Reyna Perez operating the point. Perez zips it out. Kanane. Crutchfield, she got it. How clutch is Kai Crutchfield?
That's why they call it what, Rye?
Crutchfield. 2-point game, 14 for Kai Crutchfield. Olivia Miles directing traffic. Here comes Mabry. Under 2 minutes to go. Miles into the lane. Cups it up in! No angle too difficult for Olivia Miles. Four-point game again. Crutchfield a 3. No. Rebound Jones, which just left the room. Miles standing there watching Kayla Jones put it back in. Two-point game. 1:15 to go. Miles through the double team and a timeout taken by Neil Ivey. Looked like Miles might have had a lane to the rim. Instead, timeout Notre Dame with 1:13 to go and the Fighting Irish leading by 2.
Especially for a young player, Olivia Miles has such a great sense of time as she comes in and delivers the dime perfectly. And then Kai Crutchfield coming off the screen. I mean, she has been so impactful on both ends of the floor. Hey, big girl, I'm going to go by it, and I'm going to go by everybody else and score. Wow. What a game for the freshman.
Notre Dame with 1 foul to give. NC State with 4. NC State has the possession arrow. Plenty of timeouts in both teams' arsenal to be able to navigate down the stretch. Remember, Miles did get a cup of coffee with Notre Dame last season when incoming freshmen were allowed to begin their collegiate careers a bit early, but her status is still as a freshman this year, and she has been terrific, 21 points, 6 assists. Here is Mabry. Into Miles. Kanane came with the hedge, got back to Dodson. Miles, 2-point game, under a minute to go. A trip to the Elite Eight on the line. Miles, a 3, no good. Box out Kanane, NC State a chance to tie or take the lead.
Incredible box out by Elisa Kanane, allowing her to get that board.
Perez. Over to Jones, Kanane, one-on-one. Kanane for the tie, she gets fouled by Dodson. It will be Dodson's 4th, and Kanane, an outstanding free throw shooter, will have 2 to try and tie this game.
Elisa Kanane has looked like a senior on a mission here all game long.
Mom watching. Kanane has the first.
My stomach hurts for her mom's stomach.
Kanane has been money at the line. 6 of 6 today. Misses that one. Dodson the rebound. And a timeout taken by Notre Dame as mom deals with the stress and the drama. Notre Dame's lead is still 1.
That's every mom's reaction.
So Notre Dame with the basketball. Now, Rebecca, this is interesting. When you look at the clock, there's a 5-second difference between the game and shot clock. NC State still has 4 fouls to give. Is that enough of a difference for them to play straight up defense here against Notre Dame trailing by 1?
At least initially for sure, because they've been able to wreak havoc. You've got to give them opportunities here to try to wreak some havoc, at least at first.
NC State has not been to the Elite Eight since 1998. They are 1-13 all time in Sweet 16s. Meanwhile, it's been a real quick turnaround from Notre Dame. After a 10-10 season last year, they're right back on this big stage in year 2 under Neil Ivey. Citron will inbound. Has to get it in. It's off of Westbelt, or is it? They're going to take a look. As Jones was there, they will review who this hit last and whether or not this might be NC State possession.
And of course, the call on the floor, always so important. Call on the floor was Notre Dame ball. Is this going to be
last
clear?
Play is under review.
Clear and conclusive, right?
Karen Priato, Roy Gulbayan, William Smith, our officials today. You think about it, Rebecca. It has been a game without many stoppages. Initially called out on Kayla Jones. I'm not sure anything there is going to change the call. Let's see. My guess is that's going to remain as it stands, Rebecca. What do you think?
There's nothing clear and conclusive to overturn it.
It's the right hand of Jones coming through. The left hand of Westbelt on the ball.
After review, play stands, Notre Dame ball.
All right, Rebecca, so Notre Dame keeps possession. They had trouble with the inbound there. Interesting. Now, the shot clock didn't start, but the game clock did there. And now they're going to put the clock back to 34.7, so that's why. It was at 35, so 34.7 up from 33.9. Citron, get it in. Westbelt, surrounded. Able to shake free for a moment, and a foul is called against NC State. And look, Rebecca, to your point about the strategy, they have so many fouls to give here that they can just be extraordinarily aggressive going for a steal, knowing they need to rack up those fouls anyway. Citron dumps it in, knocked out of bounds by Perez. And it's going to stay with Notre Dame. How about your Notre Dame? You have a freshman as your trusted inbounder here. In the backcourt, Miles comes to get it. Nearly had it taken away by Crutchfield. Citron gets it across with Miles. Mabry dancing away. And that's a stolen! Perez picks the pocket! Perez for the lead! NC State in front! 64-63 with 14.8 to go in the fourth.
The experience of NC State's guards on the defensive end has been the story here in the fourth quarter. Perez getting the pick. They had patience, didn't go immediately for the fouls because they believe in themselves defensively. Wow, as soon as Mabry turns, Perez is right there.
Notre Dame has not trailed since early in the second quarter, and Wes Moore has seen his team overcome a double-digit deficit. Reyna Perez with NC State's 12th steal of the game, and now Notre Dame, Rebecca, uses its final timeout.
And number one, they've got to make sure they can inbound the basketball. They've had a tough time here the last couple of times on the sideline getting a clean look in. Of course, you would expect them to get the ball to Olivia Miles. I would come up and set a on ball with your big and then let her go to work.
A 13-4 NC State run to take the lead. And remember, NC State still has fouls to give as well. Here is Miles, down one. Miles, with 8 seconds left. Miles, out of the double. West Belt for the lead. No! Rebound, Perez. Fouled by Notre Dame. 1.5 to go. NC State on the brink.
Notre Dame gets a great look. Two goes to Miles. Westbelt, a clean look at the basket. Wes Moore feeling it.
And remember, Notre Dame is out of timeouts, so they cannot advance this. Perez hits the first. 2-point game. 1.5 to go in the fourth. Perez hits the second, 3-point game. Just time for a heave. Here's Citron, does she get it off? She does not, that's it! For the first time since 1998, NC State is Elite Eight bound. This one as we take a look at our Capital One rewarding performance.
Reyna Perez just waiting to see if Mabry will turn. She does, and able to pick the pocket and finish the other way. What incredible defense once again in the fourth quarter, and a comeback by NC State.
Unbelievable comeback down the stretch. NC State using defense to get it done as they advance to the Elite Eight, and we send things over to Holly Rowe.
Well, I think NC State knows a little something about survive and advance. You had to survive this. How did your defense change the tone of this game down the stretch, Kai?
I mean, it wasn't even just my defense. You know, we came together as a team. We knew what we had to do, and we executed.
These were clutch moments. You get the steal. You hit the three. How are you able to be so comfortable right then?
I mean, you said it, just being comfortable in this moment. I mean, it's March. My teammates believe in me. My coaches believe in me. My family believes in me. And I know we were able to knock it down.
All along the way, people did not believe in you. They thought you were too small, but you never gave up hope in yourself. Reyna, how did you get that steal and that go-ahead basket in that moment?
Defense is all about heart. I mean, I knew we were down. I knew we needed a steal, and I just tried to lock in.
You have to step up. First, you get the rebound on this end. Then you step up for free throws. How did you be strong in that moment?
I mean, we do pressure free throws all the time. We practice this. I knew I could do it, and so I'm just so happy I knocked them down.
You got eliminated in this round last year. Why did you refuse to let that happen today.
It's a hump that we had to get over. And I mean, the girls are determined, I'm determined, we made it happen.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
What defense down the stretch for Kai Crutchfield and Reyna Perez as NC State conquers the mountain they couldn't a season ago. They are headed to the Elite Eight for just the second time in school history. They await to see whether or not they will face UConn or Indiana. That game is coming up next on ESPN. Once again, the final score, NC State 66, Notre Dame 63. Indiana UConn is coming up next, but time to go to Degree in the studio. L. Duncan, Nikki Fargus, and Monica McNutt. L.
Thank you, Ryan Rucco. Oh my goodness.
Yes.
Degree is in the studio. I am Elle Duncan. She is Nikki Fargus. She is Monica McNutt. We don't have a dog necessarily in this fight, but let me tell you, we were your grandmothers. We were your mothers. We were your kin. We were your family watching the end of that game. Just an absolutely thrilling contest. Your biggest takeaway from what you just saw in our first game.
I still feel like I need to walk it out.
Right?
Like, this is just my nerves. The fortitude. And yes. I hate to go away from stats because we could dig into the stats all day, but the fortitude of NC State. Olivia Miles at halftime was unguardable.
Yes.
Darren Mabry hitting shots. Maddie Westfeld pulling up, knocking down threes. Maya Dotson comes off the bench with an abundance of energy, and NC State is steady.
Yes.
All the while, remembering that, what, the last five times they've been in the NCAA tournament,
yes,
this is where they have bowed out. They were steady. Reyna Perez, Elisa Kunane down the stretch, the last two baskets that earned her trips to the free throw line, even the one that she missed, though, but just putting herself in that position, just steady. Like, I'm, whew.
Well, this game is a game of runs, and NC State was able to put together a run in the last minute 23 to go on the 7-0 run. And, you know, your heart, someone's going to lose.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody can't get a blue ribbon. But I will tell you that this time of year, ball control, making sure that you secure every possession. The thing that NC State is really good at is obviously their defense, and they were able to turn them over. So what, when you're sitting here like looking and you're like, ooh, Notre Dame is 100% in control of this, right? Up one, the question was, shouldn't NC State foul? They decide not to, and then Perez with the major, major steal to put Notre Dame in a very hard predicament with 14.8 seconds, because they were ahead. They were controlling the game. You control the game because you controlled the possession. But once that steal happened, now the control and the momentum, it went to NC State.
Ooh.
16 turnovers for Notre Dame, none bigger than that one,
mm-hmm,
at the very end. We sort of heard NC State refer to it a little bit with Holly, and you referred to it as well. Getting over this hump. For those, again, that don't know, coming into this game, NC State had one of the worst records of all time in the Sweet 16. And for a lot of these girls in particular, their season has ended in the Sweet 16 time and time and time again. Just mentally, what does it mean to, at the very least, be able to get over this proverbial hump and move on to the next round?
Well, celebrate it. You know, be
enjoy it for sure.
Yeah.
This was a hard-fought game between two very, very good teams, and the possession went into NC State's favor. But you can't just rely on this game to get you to the next game. So enjoy it, because tomorrow your focus now needs to be on who comes out of the bracket, at the bottom of the bracket. But I will say this, NC State, and having followed NC State, they're a team that has had ups and downs.
Of course.
And they've had peaks and valleys. And the thing that's been consistent with them is their ability to defend and rebound the basketball. So when you're turning people over like they did, they had 22 points off of those turnovers. You're stealing possessions away from other opponents, and they do that better than anybody in the country.
They shot the ball at a 47.7% clip in this ball game as well. But you're right, it's the combination of defense. And then you look at the types of baskets that they were able to get. Points in the paint, 36.
Mm-hmm.
And
yep,
so they gave themselves the opportunity. And Reyna Perez steps up in that moment. Like, we can pick this thing,
yep,
apart.
Yes.
But if Reyna Perez doesn't make that play, it could obviously go very differently.
It could have gone very differently. We also would be remiss to not shout out Notre Dame.
Excellent
ball game. They are so young.
Yeah.
They are going to be here again with most of their starters returning. It was really win it now or never for NC State, with four of their five starters moving on after this year. But they don't have to worry about moving on just yet, because they are moving on to the Elite Eight. Of course, the winner of this game between UConn and Indiana will face NC State after, listen, our researcher Jenny was like, I'm still trying to unpack what I saw in this game. It's a game that was on earlier. Kai Crutchfield, you could call her Kai. Clutchfield was huge for NC State. Olivia Miles with the layup here. So this was a good back and forth. It goes 63-59, a minute 25 to play. After an offensive rebound, Kayla Jones with the layup. NC State's back within two. Then 16 seconds. This is the play that will haunt Notre Dame.
Down the play.
Mabry gets her pocket picked by Reyna Perez. Take another look, because again, NC State wasn't winning this game until here.
And there was so much confusion here, because I believe NC State still had three fouls to give before they would put Notre Dame in the bonus. And you wonder why Olivia Miles didn't have the basketball. Just a bad decision by Mabry.
One more chance for Notre Dame, who fought valiantly, but finally NC State is elite. Here's Wes Moore, their head coach.
We were very fortunate. What can you say about Reyna? I mean, you know, Beyonce's big, but Reyna blows her away, you know? I mean, come on. 2 years in a row. Last year, she hits the jumper to win the ACC tournament. Now this year, she picks, you know, gets a pick there when it looked it looked like it was going to be pretty hard. Unbelievable. But the whole team, just so proud of them.
The maturity of this team, this entire season, the belief, the buy-in, I could not ask for another special group. I love them so much, and I'm just so proud. But again, like, this is hard. You know, it's going to take a long time to recover.
Well, especially because Notre Dame was in firm control the last 6 minutes of this game. And it's as if NC State said, not today, Devil. We are so tired of y'all reminding us that we can't get past the Sweet 16. Look what they were able to do down the stretch there, Nikki. Just fantastic.
It was unbelievable. And, you know, you talk about the one play by Reyna Perez. She obviously was not having a great offensive outing. She only made connected on one three-pointer, and I love her at the three ball. But the other thing that she was able to do defensively was stay rooted to what they do best, and that is defend, and they were able to get the turnover, and that was such a huge steal.
Reyna Perez, by the way,
talk to me.
Right? Gets the game clinching steal, game winning steal and layup, and compared to Beyonce in the same
game. I'm glad that you leaned into that one, Elle, because I was thinking Wes Moore is making Beyonce references. What a day.
What's happening?
Because Reyna clearly told the girls, okay, ladies, let's get into formation.
Get in formation.
Okay, we are going on to the Elite Eight. But, after the game, the first word that came to me was fortitude.
Uh-huh.
We talked about Alyssa Cunane not necessarily having to be the star player that we saw during the course of the regular season so far in this tournament, but in this ball game, she came. She showed up in fine fashion, and she did what she's capable of doing. And the play by Reyna is huge, but over the course of that 6 minutes, everybody does a little bit here, a little bit there. Kayla Jones, Jada Boyd, I think had gone out right before that run had started, but she kept them at bay with some energy plays prior to that. Ja'Kia Brown-Turner finds a basket. And so it was really the semblance of this team that has developed sincerely for NC State.
And shout out to Notre Dame, Dara Mabry. A lot of people going to talk about that last play, but she is where they were. They, in part, were where they were because of her and Olivia Miles, who were fantastic. No doubt we will see you on this very big stage again.